Hi everybody, we will continue the example of last time of the cantilever beam, doing some more post-processing. The example is the same, the geometry is the same, the mesh is the same. We will go to Aster study, also with the same definition of the model. Now we will go in post-processing. We want to calculate some more fields, and we want the von Mises stresses, we want the principal stresses, for example. So we will go in CalcChamp again, and we will select criteria with CEQ-NOEU. But how can I understand well what is this CEQ-NOEU? The answer is going to the documentation. I go to the documentation, the version I use, and here for utilization I will go to CalcChamp, that is the command I'm using, and here I will go for criteria, where I will find finally my CEQ-NOEU, that is this, where I have these other fields, the von Mises stresses, Tresca, the principal stresses, the von Mises signed, and the components of the principal direction of stresses. So I will print this one, I will take it from CalcChamp, and I will give you another name that is Equiv, for example. Doing that, I will create another data structure. While if I use reuse as I did in the previous CalcChamp, I will enlarge the previous data structure. So I calculated this field. Now I have to go to set output results, the previous one. I will leave the same name. I will put here another result that will be, as I said before, the new one that is equiv. And I would say that I want the nomCham, that is the name of the field, CEQ-NOEU. Here we are. Okay. Let's go to delete the previous one, calculated, and go for the next one. Now let's do some post-processing on Paravis. This time we will go in Paravis because it's a little bit more complex, the post-processing cantilever. Here we see that there is CEQ-NOEU. We will ask for CEQ-NOEU, and we have all the previously the fields we previously saw in the documentation. For example, the principal, the first principal, we see that the mesh is not so accurate. we will go now to calculate the principal vectors that, in my opinion, to know the direction of the principal vector is mandatory to understand the behavior of every structure. So generate vectors, apply, then we have to calculate manually. This procedure is not so straightforward, but it's not difficult anywhere. Here we can calculate something based on the fields that we have. We will go for scalars, and we will go here, CEQ NOEU print 1 multiplied parentheses CEQ NOEU vect 1 per yat plus CEQ NOEU vect per jyat plus the z component per kyat. Closed, apply. Now we will generate the vectors, the glyphs on that. Apply. We want solid color. We want to have it in all points. Okay, here we are. We want to reduce a little bit the arrow's size. Here we have a representation of the first principal direction. You have to do it the same for the other components to have all the three. Now we will come back to ask the study, and we will see another post-processing that will be the calculation of the stresses on a line that is here in the middle of the bottom face. So the command is the maclincoop command. We have to say what is the result we want. We want the ResLin calcchamp, because in the ResLin calcchamp we have the signo EU. We have to define the nomCham. We can put here signo EU, we can put it here depth if we want, the displacement, and so on, everything we want. And we have to define the line cut, let's say, so the number of points of the discretization of this line, 20 points for example. And here the coordinates we want in the middle, so x50, y0, z0, then 50, 1000, because it will be at the end of the beam, and 0. Here we go. This will generate a table, so we want to print this table, imp table. We will say that we want this maclincoop. We will take a name, line cut, for example, .txt. And one more thing, we can put here in separator, the comma, to easily import it then in LibreOffice. Here we are ready, we can delete the previous result and rerun the analysis to have these new results. It's going. Here we are. So now we will go opening this line cut file we created now. I have another previous one. This is the line cut where there are all the values. We can do simply like that, Ctrl C, and then go here and go for Ctrl V. The comma ensure that everything is imported in a very fast way. And here we have the coordinates of every point we created in these 20 steps discretization. And we will go now to do a very rough chart to have a graphical feedback of the results. And as we say, oh sorry, finish. And as we say, it's kind of linear, some problems of the mesh as before. Last topic will be to put a cut on the zone with this one, apply. And you will have the possibility to cut as you want your field. For today it's all, and I hope that you are enjoying this lessons, and live long and prosper.